السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. This is Muhammad Mahfouz from Foodics. Today I'm going to show you how to update the manage roles features inside Foodics. To access the manage roles feature, you have to go to settings, then choose employees page. Then it will open for you the list of employees that you have inside Foodics. Then the next part is by clicking manage role button, you will access the manage roles. In this part, we have four types of roles inside Foodics. So we have company role, business role, branch role, and app role. App role is dedicated for the users or the app users who is using Foodics apps inside your branch. The rest of the roles here is applicable or dedicated for the web users that or who has access to the dashboard to work on it. So we will start with the company role to add a new one. So add my company role, for example, the name. Then you choose the authority for this role. So for example, I'm gonna choose three or four types of authorities regarding this company role. Then I hit save. Now it will be saved, as we can see. The next part we have is the business role. Again, you can create it my business role. Then you will assign some authorities of this role. For example, I'm gonna choose one. He can access the menu, can access the payment method, coupons, discount, and so on for the taxes. And you can choose from the rest of list of authorities. Then you click save. It will be saved again, as we can see. The next one, which is for branches. So we can, let's say, name it central branches, for example, role. Then go again to the authorities. This role for the central branches, he can access the device, floor tables, and branch settings, orders. And for example, let's choose, he can ask or he can see and access the inventory report, advanced reports, and for example, view snapshots and manage menu activation, as for example. Then click save. As we can see, it has been added successfully. The last one we have is for the app user. Again, let's say, let's name it as a main app role. The next one we have the authorities for this one. For example, the main one, he can access some of the authorities for the app. For example, I'm gonna choosing randomly. Then hit save. Again, it will be saved and shown, as we can see, in front of us. The next step that we need to do is go back to the settings, then employees page, then assign those roles to specific employees that I have in under my account in Foodics. So for example, I'm gonna add a new app user. For example, app user, we call it app user, for example, the name. Then the code is 12345. The username, I will copy the same. Then I will assign a role for this app user. Again, the app role depends on the list that you have added in manage role. It will be shown here. So again, we have just added the main app role. It will be show it will be shown here, as we can see. So I will choose it. Then I will choose this app user that I'm gonna create this applicable to work in which branch. So he just only work in Riyadh and Jeddah, for example. Then click save. So it will be added, as we can see here, in web user. App user. The next one we have is the web user. We click on add a new web user. Then name it again. Let's say web user, for example, one. Then his email will be user1 at someone.com, then the password, for example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then in the roles part, you're gonna assign some roles for this web user. So branch role, I'm gonna choose the central branch role that I have added previously. Then in which branch he's applicable to access through the dashboard, from the name of this central branch role, I have to choose that Riyadh, because I name it as a central branch and Riyadh in the central region of Saudi Arabia. So I have chosen Riyadh. By the way, you can choose multiple branches, but for now let's use one branch. The next one we have is the business role. If you wish to give him a role and access authorities for those business role, you can choose it. The last one, again, for the company role. If you need to let him access the company role, just you need to assign to him. So click save. It will be saved here as we can see for this web user. For example, if you add a new, for example, web user, and you did not assign any role for this user. For example, I'm gonna use user one, for example, this name, then his email would be at g.com, the password into 3, 4, and you just save without adding any role. You just hit save. It will be saved and added into the system, but with a red background, as we can see. That means this user or web user doesn't have any role under his account. So you must assign a role for his account, so he can access it in the dashboard. I hope everything was clear regarding the managed role, and I wish you a happy and good day. Thank you so much.